You should do it because it's going to help you lose weight, it's going to help clear up your skin, it's going to help get rid of your digestive issues like constipation, bloating, and gas. It's going to give you energy. Peace, my name is Noman, aka SoulFlow. Just so you know, this video is not sponsored or anything. I'm not getting paid to promote some product or something like that. I'm literally just sharing from my experience and from the research that I've done to try and help people. Quick note before we get into it, if you are pregnant or trying to become pregnant, don't do this cleanse. Okay, so what is the gut cleanse and what are we really trying to do with it? To put it simply, we're taking out the bad stuff and we're replacing it with good stuff. So that means we're getting rid of the parasites, we're getting rid of fungal overgrowth, we're getting rid of the bad bacteria, and we're replacing it with good bacteria, with probiotics, healthy gut bacteria. And we're healing your gut lining, which is very, 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 very important. It's going to help with your mental health. If you have anxiety or depression, this is going to help if you're obviously also making other smart choices like dietary choices and, you know, reducing stress and stuff like that. But this is going to help because there's a huge connection between your gut and brain. 90% of your serotonin and 50% of your dopamine is actually produced where? Not in here, but actually it's produced in your gut. And so that's why this has such a big impact on your mental health. Okay, so how do we actually do the cleanse? Well, we need to have a specific diet. We're going to take supplements that's going to get rid of the fungus and the parasites. And we're going to heal the gut lining with a supplement. And we're going to replace with probiotics. Kind of optional, but I recommend it. It's to take something that will bind to the toxins and pull out the toxins from your body. Because while you're doing this cleanse, when you kill parasites and when you kill fungus, they're going to release toxins in your body. And because of this, you might get a headache, you might feel tired. These are called Herxheimer reactions or die-off symptoms, which is perfectly normal and is a sign that you're doing the cleanse properly, so don't worry. But like I said, if you're taking something like bentonite clay or activated charcoal, it will help bind to those toxins and pull them out of your body so that while you're doing the cleanse, you don't experience these die-off symptoms as much. How long you have to do this cleanse, it depends on you. Depends on your body, depends on how many parasites are inside of you, how bad your gut is. So it really depends, but on average, 1 month is a good amount of time to aim for. And then if you need to do more, depending on your body, you can do more. You can do it for 2 months or 3 months, as long as you need. Diet for the cleanse. What can you eat and what can't you eat? You cannot eat refined sugars. Okay, that means no juice, no Coke, no cookies, no ice cream, no desserts, no nothing. That's gonna be a little bit hard for some people. It was hard for me because I had strong sugar cravings. But ironically, sugar cravings are caused by what? By parasites and fungal overgrowth. That's what gives you those strong sugar cravings where you have to have something sweet after every meal. You're looking for a cookie, you're looking for ice cream. That's why, because they feed on refined sugars, the parasites and fungus overgrowth. No refined carbs. Okay, that means no bread, no pasta, no pizza. Try to avoid potatoes, they're very starchy as well. So you're basically trying to avoid anything that's sweet and anything that is starchy. Okay, what you're going to be eating during the cleanse mainly is vegetables, okay? As many vegetables as you possibly can. Also, you want to eat lots of seeds, like chia seeds, hemp seeds, papaya seeds especially. Those are anti-parasitic. And you can have some meat, that's fine. You can have chicken, you can have beef. Try to get it from a good meat source, obviously. Fruits are a little bit controversial. Some people will say no fruits at all. They're very strict about it. And some people will say, no, that's all right. I'm not as strict on it. I would just say avoid the sweet and starchy fruits, especially like banana, for example. Avoid bananas. But you can have like green apples. They're not that sweet. You can have berries. Should be fine. It's really up to you. I had some fruits here and there during my cleanse and I was fine. I got rid of the parasites. So that's kind of a personal thing. Now I'm going to break down everything you need to buy in order to do the cleanse. Okay, so the first thing you're going to need is two herbal supplements that will kill the parasites. The first herbal supplement that's going to kill the adult parasites is called Mimosa Pudica Capsules, okay? You can get that online from Amazon. I'll put a link below. What it is a plant, and you're using the seeds of this particular plant. It's also called the sensitive plant or the shy plant, and that's because when you touch this plant, it actually reacts to your touch and it folds up its leaves. So that's why they call it sensitive or touch me not plant. But the seeds of this particular plant, it creates this very sticky type of substance. And that sticky substance is what you take in a capsule form. You take it and it goes through your gut and it will stick to the parasites, the adult parasites, and literally physically pull them out. And it's probably the most effective thing in my experience that I've used to get rid of adult parasites, hands down. The second herbal supplement is a combination of different herbs, okay? There's a bunch of different products, a bunch of different companies that sell it. But you want to look out for three main ingredients. You want to look out for black walnut, wormwood, and cloves. Those are the three ingredients you want to look for. You can probably find a product in a health store near you, or you can just look on Amazon. There's a product called Paraguard that has it. There's a few other ones as well. You can kind of pick whichever one you want, but those are the three ingredients you want to look for. I'll put a link below so you can have some options for that. When I first started my cleanse, I was only taking the black walnut, wormwood, and cloves. And I was reading that that would kill all of them, the adults as well. But in my experience and the experience of people that I know who've tried it, it seems to not be as effective in killing the adult ones. After 2 weeks of just using the, you know, the black walnut, didn't really see any parasites come out. Then once I started using the Mimosa pudica, that's when I saw the adult parasites come out, and it was disgusting, but very, very effective. There's another thing that's really, really good at killing parasites, and it's called diatomaceous earth. It's kind of optional, like if you really don't have the money, you don't have to buy it, but it is very effective. It's like this white powder, and I'll put a link below to an article about diatomaceous earth from a doctor who really knows this stuff. So you can read that for more information and the benefits of diatomaceous earth. But if you do buy it and you do take it during the cleanse, just keep in mind it's going to make you thirsty. So make sure you drink a lot of water if you are taking diatomaceous earth. The second supplement with the black walnut and wormwood and cloves, that one is antifungal. It's killing the fungal overgrowth as well. A lot of herbs you'll find, they're antiparasitic, but also antifungal and antimicrobial. And that's the good thing about herbs. They do a lot of different things, right? Okay, so that was all focused on killing the parasites and getting rid of the fungal overgrowth. The second thing we want to focus on is healing your gut lining. Okay, and this is very, 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 very important. Inside your gut, right, if you want to think of your intestines like this, it has a lining that's protecting it. It's kind of like a wall, and it's a wall that protects you. So when you eat food, for example, usually what happens is you have nutrients that are very, very tiny that goes through the gut lining and into your bloodstream. And from there, the blood carries the nutrients to all your organs and throughout your body. And because the gut lining is very tight, it doesn't allow toxins and undigested food particles from going through, because that's bad and that would cause a lot of problems. But unfortunately, that's what's happening with a lot of people. It's called increased intestinal permeability, but it's also more commonly known as leaky gut. And what leaky gut is when you have little spaces in your gut lining. So it's not as protective anymore. So now you have undigested food particles and toxins that pass through and go into your bloodstream, and that causes all sorts of problems. What causes your increased intestinal permeability? Well, number one, parasites cause that because they start eating away at your intestinal lining. It's also years of eating a bad diet full of inflammatory foods. Probably the biggest cause of leaky gut is antibiotics. Unless you really need it, try not to take antibiotics. Doctors nowadays, they seem to like just prescribe it like it's nothing, but it can cause a lot of problems. You have good bacteria that you absolutely need in your gut and your entire body to protect you. And so the antibiotics gets rid of the infection, which is great, but it also gets rid of your good bacteria. And that's a really bad problem. That's going to leave you with a leaky gut. What happens is you have a yeast or a fungus in your gut called Candida. And Candida is supposed to be there. The problem is when you kill off the healthy bacteria, that healthy bacteria was keeping the fungus in check and keeping things balanced. But when you kill off the healthy bacteria, now the fungus starts to grow like crazy because they don't have this healthy bacteria to kind of balance things. So then you have fungal overgrowth, which keeps overgrowing, and that can eventually lead to leaky gut. So we need to take a supplement that will basically take your gut from being like this, your gut lining, to making it nice and tight and protective, to prevent any toxins from going through, and to heal the mucous membrane that's protecting it. So I'll put links below to a supplement that will do this, that will heal your gut lining very well. They have L-glutamine. They have marshmallow root, which is an amazing herb for the digestive system. They have slippery elm, which is, again, another amazing herb. They have quercetin dihydrate. Quercetin is an amazing thing as well that is great for your whole body, for your immune system. You can search on Amazon or anywhere for leaky gut repair, and you will find, usually they come in powder form, and those are the ingredients you want to look for. Okay, so the third thing we need to focus on is probiotics, okay? And that just means healthy gut bacteria. Like I mentioned before, you have bad bacteria and then you have good bacteria that you absolutely need in your gut. You can get probiotics from a supplement from a health store, or you can eat fermented foods like sauerkraut, like kimchi, like kombucha, like apple cider vinegar. Fermented foods are great. Some people, like for example, people who have SIBO, small intestinal bacterial overgrowth, they don't tolerate fermented foods very well, and it kind of messes with their stomach when they eat those type of foods. So for those people, I would say you can start doing the fermented foods a little bit later on in your cleanse. So as you're killing off the parasites and you're healing your gut lining and you're getting rid of the fungus overgrowth, then you should be able to tolerate the fermented foods a little bit more over time as you're doing the cleanse. So what you can do is kind of experiment a little and try a little bit of sauerkraut, try a little bit of kimchi and see how your body reacts. And slowly you can increase the amount that you add if you can tolerate it. Okay, so the next thing we need to focus on, I think it's number four, is something that will bind to the toxins and pull them out of your body. As I mentioned before, when you're killing parasites and fungus, they release toxins as they're dying. And those toxins can make you feel tired, can give you a headache, it can maybe give you a little bit of an upset stomach or something like that. These are all called die-off symptoms. So to reduce the die-off symptoms and to help remove the toxins from your body quickly, you can take something like bentonite clay. And what it does is you take it in a powder form. You can put it in some water, drink it once a day. I believe it's like 1 teaspoon. You should follow the label. But what that does is it's going to bind to the toxins and pull those toxins out of your body. And that will reduce the symptoms that you feel during the cleanse, so you won't feel as tired during the cleanse or weak. You can also take activated charcoal and it will do the same thing, but it's not really for long-term use, so I wouldn't recommend doing it every day of the cleanse because it can prevent you from absorbing nutrients. So it's not something you want to just take regularly. So I would recommend bentonite clay. You should always have activated charcoal at home, by the way. If you ever eat something and you feel like you might get food poisoning, or you just ate some old meat or something like that, you should definitely take activated charcoal because it will pull out the bacteria and the toxins. I spent 2 months in India and I didn't get sick at all because I had activated charcoal. People came to India with like bagfuls of medicine and they all got sick and I didn't. Even though I felt like I was going to get sick at certain times, and it's all thanks to activated charcoal. But yeah, I think it's a good idea to have something to help remove the toxins at least a few times during the cleanse. All right, moving on. So the next one, I think is number five, is to use a natural laxative. This one is optional, but is very helpful for people who are not going to the bathroom very often. As I mentioned before, parasites and fungus, when you kill them, they are releasing toxins. So you have these toxins and parasites and fungus and bad bacteria and all kinds of stuff just sitting in your gut. That's not good. You want it to keep things moving. You want to go to the bathroom regularly, right? So for people who are constipated, or you know, maybe you only go once a day, or not even once a day, sometimes you just don't go the whole day, that's not good at all. It's not good in general, and it's especially not good during the cleanse. You want to make sure that you're going to the bathroom regularly to flush things out. So that's where a natural laxative can be very helpful. I'll put a link below for a natural laxative that is herbal and has a combination of really good herbs. And it's made by Dr. Christopher, who is no longer alive, but he was one of the best herbalists. And he's amazing. I've studied a lot of his work. I'll put a link below. You can check that one out. If you're someone who's constipated, I highly recommend you do that. Another option you have is you can take black seed oil daily. Black seed oil is amazing for your entire body, but it's especially good for your digestive system. So you can take 1 teaspoon of black seed oil every day, and that will help keep things moving. Just a side note, there's a lot of controversy when it comes to bathroom business. If you're going to the bathroom less than once a day, some people will tell you that's normal. Even doctors, some doctors will tell you, oh, that's all right, everyone's different. That's not all right, because your digestive system is clearly being slowed down. Think about it, you're eating like 4 or 5 times a day. Well, we say 3 times a day, like 3 big meals, but you're eating a lot more. You're eating snacks in between, right? So you're eating like 4 or 5 times a day, and you're not taking out the trash, you know what I mean? The slower your digestion is, the more chances of disease forming. So you need to improve that system, and this gut cleanse is going to do that. It's going to improve your digestive system and keep things moving, especially if you do an enema, which brings me to number six. Number six is to do an enema. This is optional as well, but if you are very constipated, then you should probably do an enema. An enema is amazing during the cleanse. A lot of people are going to get uncomfortable about the idea of an enema. And I'm not going to lie, it's kind of uncomfortable. I put a link to a video below that has a lot of information about enemas, how to do them, why people do them, what they are. But essentially, an enema is flushing out your intestines with water. If you think of your intestines as pipes, over the years, if you've ever looked inside a pipe after like 40 years or 30 years, you'll see the inside of the pipe has all kinds of nasty stuff building up in it. If you look in your sink or things like that, in your intestines, the same thing is happening. There's some nasty things that get stuck up in your intestines over the years. So an enema is a great thing that will flush out your intestines and flush all that nasty stuff out. If you're going, like, let's say not even once a day, you should definitely do an enema. I'll put a link to a really nice video below from a cool YouTuber who's kind of funny, but he also knows his stuff about health. And he explains how to do the enema and why to do it in great detail. So you can follow his video if you want to check it out. You can get an enema kit, which is what you'll need to do an enema. You can just order one off Amazon. I believe some health stores have it as well. I'll put a link below for that as well. And lastly, number 7, we have intermittent fasting. Okay, fasting is very, very important in general for overall health, but especially during this cleanse. When you fast, you are starving the parasites and the fungus. They need food just like you do to survive, right? So when you starve them, you have a better chance of killing them. I did intermittent fasting throughout the cleanse, and I highly, highly recommend you do it as well. It's up to you how you want to do it, how often you want to do it, how long you want to fast. It's up to you. But some days I would wake up and I wouldn't eat breakfast, and I'd be like, okay, I'm going to fast today until evening, and then I would eat in the evening. Some days what I would do is I would eat breakfast, eat lunch, and then I would eat something small, and the last time I would eat would be around 6 p.m. And after 6 p.m. I would stop eating. And then the next following day, that's when I would do an enema. And the reason why is because when you do an enema, your gut should be completely empty. You don't want to have leftover food, because sometimes food can sit in your gut for a whole day, or sometimes even more depending on your digestive system. So you want to stop eating the day before, maybe like 5, 6 p.m. stop eating. And then take some laxatives that night. Take a lot of the natural laxatives, take black seed oil, take the other laxative, and that will basically empty out your stomach. So you're going to the bathroom, flushing things out, your gut is getting empty. You wake up in the morning, take another laxative so that you go to the bathroom if you need to. You want to completely empty out your stomach, and then you do the enema so that the water is flushing through your intestines and washing away whatever's left in your intestines. Because you stopped eating, and you went to the bathroom, so your gut should be empty. But it's not. Like I said, there's a lot of stuff that gets built up in your intestines. And what comes out, there's going to be a lot of nasty stuff coming out that shows you that that thing has been stuck in your intestines for years, right? So anyways, intermittent fasting is very important throughout the cleanse. You're starving the parasites and the fungus. I'm going to break it down in 3 different stages. So there's the preparation stage before the cleanse, how you prepare for the cleanse. Yes, you have to prepare for the cleanse. There's the actual cleanse itself, and then there is the last part, which is maintenance after the cleanse. So to prepare your preparation stage, you have to start by doing the diet. Okay, you want to start the diet before you actually do the cleanse. That will give your body kind of a head start for the cleanse. Okay, so that means you want to cut out the refined sugars and carbs, and you want to start eating a lot of veggies and do intermittent fasting. Another thing you can do to prepare for the cleanse is a liver cleanse. Some people may need to do a more in-depth liver cleanse. If you have any sort of liver problems, or if you have a lot of toxins built up in your body, or if you drink a lot of alcohol, you probably have some liver issues there. Do a more in-depth liver cleanse first before you do the gut parasite cleanse. And the reason is because, like I mentioned, these parasites and fungus, they release toxins as they're dying, and your liver is what has to deal with all these toxins. So it's a good idea to cleanse your liver first so that it's not overwhelmed when you do the gut cleanse. Okay, so that's how you prepare for the cleanse. So I think the best way to do it is order the supplements that you need for the cleanse. And while you're waiting for the supplements to arrive, which usually takes at least a week, you can do your preparation. And then once these supplements arrive, then you can start your cleanse. Okay, so once you start the cleanse, you're going to be taking the supplements daily. You obviously should follow the label of the product that you buy. I also took the diatomaceous earth once in a while, maybe once every 4 days during the cleanse. But again, that's just for me, and you kind of do what works for you. Once you're done the cleanse, then you go into the maintenance phase, which means you're just going to maintain your health from now on. which means you can start eating sugar and carbs again once you're done the cleanse, but just try and reduce that amount. The other thing you want to do is eat more fermented foods in general. They're amazing for your gut. Another thing is you want to avoid eating sushi and pork because those two foods are known and infamous for containing parasites. And avoid undercooked meat. You always want to cook your meat really, really well. That increases your chances of, you know, killing off any parasites if they're in the meat. For general maintenance moving forward, it's a good idea to have a bottle of that tincture of black walnut, wormwood, and cloves. And every now and then just take some. And that wormwood and the black walnut is going to kind of stay in your system for a while and prevent any parasites. So if you were to accidentally take parasites in that time, if you had that in your system, the black walnut, the wormwood, and cloves, is going to prevent those parasite eggs from actually hatching and then a new infestation taking over your body. So it's good to kind of occasionally have that on hand and just take a little bit here and there. If you're ever traveling, you want to make sure that you have some kind of anti-parasitic herbs with you. Okay, so there's a lot of information in this video, so you can save this video and keep it on hand so you can refer to it if you need to during the cleanse. Go on YouTube and search Dr. J. Davidson Parasites. He had Lyme disease himself and he ended up finding out the connection between parasites and Lyme disease. I'm just going to leave you with some final thoughts and some important notes to take away. So again, if you are pregnant or trying to become pregnant, don't do this cleanse. The Mimosa pudica capsules, they kind of have like a contraceptive properties. So it's almost like taking birth control. And as always, whenever you start a new product or a new cleanse, you want to start slow so that your body has a chance to kind of react to the product and see if you have a negative reaction. Maybe you're allergic to something. So it's always good to be on the safe side. Start with a small amount and then gradually build your way up. As always, it's very important to research things for yourself before you start anything. And you can consult your doctor. I feel like most conventional doctors don't really know much about a herbal parasite cleanse. So I don't know how much they can help you, but it's still a good idea to run it by them. Okay, that was a lot of information to go through. If you have any questions, leave a comment below or send me a DM and I will try to get back to everyone. If there's anything that I forgot, I'll probably put it in the description below. So always check the description. All that I ask is if this video, this knowledge, and this cleanse helps you heal from your disease or from your conditions, if you could please go to your doctor and get a document that actually shows that you had this problem and this problem, this problem on this date, so when it started, and then you did the cleanse and now you don't have these problems anymore. If you can get that printed out and send it to me, or even a picture on your phone and send it to me, that would be amazing, because I want to have actual documented proof that this cleanse and healing your gut is going to be healing diseases. I'm going to leave you guys with one of my favorite quotes from Hippocrates, who said over 2,000 years ago, he said, all disease begins in the gut. And if you want to heal, you have to address your gut. And this is what all true healers have known for many, many, many thousands of years. So I really hope you take that in mind and understand the importance of your gut health. And I hope this video helps you heal. Peace.